Hello friends, in today's session we are going to discuss about dielectric materials under solid state physics. All of us know dielectric materials are the insulators. Basically these insulators are dielectric materials. Dielectric materials are having different categories based on the dipole moment that they possess or does not possess. So basically dielectric materials are the insulators, and they have either permanent dipoles or induced dipoles in the presence of external electric field. Now let us see what is a dipole and how exactly it contributes for some other electric field, etc. A dipole is an entity in which equal positive and negative charges are separated by a small distance. If you look at this figure, these are the charges Q and this is minus Q, separated by a distance x. So this particular entity is known as the dipole. Di stands for 2. It consists of two charges, plus Q and minus Q, separated by a distance x. If the distance is zero, you cannot call it as a dipole. An entity is said to be a dipole if there are two charges separated by a fixed distance, and that dipole is associated with its dipole moment. It is characterized with this moment, dipole moment. It is the product of magnitude of either of the charges or and the separation between them. Here charge either plus Q or minus Q, separation is x, therefore its dipole moment mu equal to Q into x. Larger the strength of the charge, more is the dipole moment. Similarly, larger the separation, more is the dipole moment. So in order to understand these dielectric materials, you have to have a sound knowledge or knowledge on magnitude of this dipole moment. So mu is Q into x. Now basically, depending on the nature of these dipoles, the dielectrics are classified into two categories: non-polar dielectrics and polar dielectrics, based on the type of dipole moment or dipole present. In the non-polar dipoles, we will discuss this first. There is no permanent dipole moment in the absence of the external electric field. So non-polar means this is the type of dipole wherein positive and negative charges coincide each other. That is non-polar. The separation is zero. See, here centroids of positive and negative charges of molecules constituting the dielectric material, they coincide, which means plus and minus charge coincide over one another and x equal to zero. Such dipoles are known as non-polar dipole. They are not polar, non-polar. Similarly, if there is permanent separation between positive and negative charges, they are said to be polar dipoles, wherein the centroids of positive and negative charges are permanently separated even in the absence of electric field. So example for polar, HCl and CO. In case of HCl, H is slightly positive, Cl is slightly negative, they are separated. Whereas in case of non-polar, say hydrogen or nitrogen, here in this molecule H and H plus and minus coincide over one another. So they are non-polar and these are the polar. So these are the two types of dielectrics, polar and non-polar. Polar means there is permanent dipole even in the absence of the external electric field. Positive and negative charges do not coincide. While coming to non-polar, there is no permanent dipole in the absence of the electric field. Positive and negative charges coincide each other. So based on this, this classification has been made. Now let us see what happens to these dipoles, either polar or non-polar, in the presence of the external field. This is very interesting. Whenever you apply an external electric field either on polar or non-polar, then there will be polarization of the medium. We call it as polarization of dielectric medium. What is this polarization? Let us see. See, in case of polar, as we have seen earlier, there is permanent separation between plus and minus charges. But in the absence of the external field, all these dipole moments are randomly oriented in space. Therefore, net dipole moment of the system becomes zero. in case of polar. Whereas in case of non-polar, though the positive and negative charge centers are not separated, net dipole moment is zero because x is zero. So in the absence of the external field, either polar or non-polar have net dipole moment zero. Now what happens whenever you apply an external field over this either permanent dipoles or polar or non-polar dipoles? So whenever you apply an external field over this, polarization takes place. That is, when an dielectric medium is kept in an external electric field, it causes electron cloud to move away from each other. Centroids of positive and negative charges get separated, inducing an electric dipole. This is known as polarization of dielectric. Or in other words, it is understood in this way: it is the process of creating or inducing dipoles in a dielectric medium by an external electric field. If the medium is polar, there is separation, there is reorientation of dipoles takes place, and there will be net dipole moment. If it is non-polar, first there is separation, then reorientation takes place. Both are known as polarization of dielectric. So it could be polar or non-polar. Polar, there will be reorientation of existing dipoles, and thereby the system has got net dipole moment. In case of non-polar, first separation takes place, then there will be reorientation. It is just like, if you think of an example, whenever the teacher enters the classroom, then all the students look at the teacher or the board. It is something like orientation. Before the entry of the teacher, all students normally look it into different directions, isn't it? So that there is net dipole moment is zero. As soon as the teacher enters the classroom, all the students look at the board or the teacher. That is somewhat polarization, reorientation of the students towards the board. So this is how you can understand polarization of dielectric medium. So now if you look at this figure, see, inside the, between the two plates, there is a dielectric medium having positive and negative charge centers. If it is polar, this is separated with respect to this minus, and if you think this as a polar, the moment when you apply external field here, these negative charge centers move towards positive plate, positive charge centers move towards negative plate because of the external field. This is polarization. So this is one molecule. You can think of infinite number of molecules. So all these charge centers move towards. If it is a non-polar, then first separation takes place. After the separation, reorientation takes place. Therefore, the effect of external electric field is either to separate the positive and negative charge centers and then orientation in case of non-polar, or direct orientation in case of polar. So this is the influence of external electric field over a dielectric medium. Thank you.